safe to say with us, South African President Cyril Ramaphosa says he would seek an urgent judicial review of a report in which the country's graft watchdog concluded that he misled Parliament over a campaign donation. Public Protector Busiswe Makwebane's report followed an investigation by the watchdog into a 500,000 rand donation to Ramaphosa's 2017 campaign for the leadership of the ruling African National Congress from the CEO of Busasa, a services company. Ramaphosa said the report findings were not rational, based in fact, or arrived at through a fair and impartial process, and that he would seek a review of the report, its conclusions, and the actions it recommended. Meanwhile, South Africa's highest court has ruled that the public protector, the state official in charge of investigating corruption, lied under oath and acted in bad faith. In a devastating judgment, the court said Busiswe Makwebane should pay a fine for her dishonesty. She is to pay some £50,000 in legal fees for her own, from her own pocket. This particular case involves a complicated dispute between the public protector and South Africa's Reserve Bank. But many of Mrs. Makwebane's recent anti-graft reports have become swamped by scandal and led to claims that she's siding with a corrupt faction within the governing ANC. As part of an annual street art festival in Morocco, local and international artists are bringing a pop of color to Casablanca. Driven by a passion for street art, this year's festival is the sixth since 2013, taking on a modern twist that focuses on contemporary ideas.
The streets of Casablanca have shone with colors as graffiti artists adorned the city's walls and buildings with modern paintings in celebration of Morocco's annual Baha Festival. The festival gives artists from all over the world the opportunity to decorate Casablanca's large buildings. According to the director of the festival, Hicham Bahou, the touch of color was welcomed by the city's residents, adding that one of the festival's goals is to sensitize people to this kind of art.
The goal of this festival is to try to import this kind of art into our country. Actually, in Morocco, we have a Moroccan street art scene. Secondly, it's about sensitizing people to this kind of art and letting them accept artistic expressions on the streets. Thankfully, we had no issues with Casablanca residents.
The festival is divided into four events: an art gallery, a skill exchanging workshop, a graffiti competition, and graffiti training sessions. The graffiti competition brought together 12 artists who each presented their artwork to an audience and before a jury, which then declared a single winner. According to Spanish street artist and judge in the competition, Maria Cano, the festival produces young talent and introduces upcoming artists.
I found that there's so many talented people that we didn't know about before. That is amazing. But it's amazing to see how they create, how they work on their style, how they construct the letters and construct the, with the colors. It's just amazing. We are very happy, very surprised.
Throughout the festival, artists were seen around Casablanca painting the sides of buildings using various painting tools and construction lifts to embellish the facades of the city's buildings.
Here in Nigeria, some inmates of the Enugu Maximum Prison have chosen music to create mental stability and raise aspiration. The group tagged Reformed are a set of young men who have acquired some skills in singing and playing musical instruments while they serve their jail terms. According to authorities, the prison, in partnership with universities and artists, are working not just to help build mental stability and rehabilitate inmates, but to help them knock out a gig and ensure stability within and outside confinement.
This is the Enugu Maximum Prison, the most prominent in the southeastern region. This prison was established in 1915 with a carrying capacity of 638 inmates. Following the increased rate of crime, this prison has since housed over 2,000 inmates who are here for various suspected crimes and sentences. Although prison overcrowding is not a new incident in carceral systems in Nigeria, its consequential damage on well-being and mental health of inmates cannot be overstated. Meet the Reform, a group of inmates in Enugu Prison who have taken to music to assuage the effects of confinement on their mental health. Freedom. That is the title of the song composed by some of those inmates who have no music orientation prior to their incarceration. But now they have gained some level of proficiency. They share the inspiration behind the songs.
1:34 night, I was sleeping. I couldn't sleep. I see the music coming to my mind. So I created the Freedom.
I will come here, rehearse, teach with people as my mind will fill with joy. I wouldn't mind that I would just wave the jail away. When I enter my cell, I will keep on rehearsing. That time I will use to think the jail. I will use it to meditate about music. Then it helped me a lot to forget my pains.
The instructors who decided to bring this mini studio described working with these inmates as an experience to savor.
Working with them gives me inspiration. You understand? Because most of them, they are so talented that people out there, they don't even know.
It has happened once in Africa, but here it's just the first time. So I decided to be part of it. So that's what brought me here.
Former inmate Chukwu Nonso is the pioneer of the Reformed group. He has also taken advantage of prison's academic program to be the 2015 best graduating student of the National Open University, a program he did within the 9 years of his jail term.
I went to the CC cell. It was a cell that cannot contain like 3 good dogs. But we were 12 there, so, you know, 6 will sleep 6 hours from 6 to 12 a.m. Then the other 6 will sleep from 12 a.m. to 6 a.m., you know. So I like being the first people that will sleep so that at the middle of the night I wake up and read. And by the grace of God, I made the overall best result in the country, the whole Nigeria.
We are putting emphasis on correction. And that one area that is vital, present area that is vital for the reformation of image is music, education. So that by the time they get this skill, if they are released, they will be able to become good members of society and also become employers.
As they look forward to freedom outside the prison, their big request is for correctional facility to be improved to meet international standards and reduce increased risk of diseases, violence, and horrendous living conditions. Nkiruka Ajogu, Channels Television News.
Never underestimate the power of music. Well, that's the program today. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Teniola Shivuale. Bye.